Yeah, good morning all of you, my dear students. Good morning, good morning. Okay, good morning to all of you. Nice to meet you all, right? For a today class, for today class, I am going to discuss with you survey adjustments and theory of errors. Actually, this is the fourth unit. Triangulation I will teach you later, right? Triangulation I will come back later. Before the triangulation, I would like to teach you because some easy calculations are there, computations are there. So I felt in the examination point of view, teaching this will be more benefited for you, right? So survey adjustment, simply it is called a theory of errors and adjustments. Theory of errors and adjustments, okay? So I don't know why your syllabus has been framed like this, I don't know. Actually, in conventional, usually for several years, the syllabus, in your syllabus, you had a chain survey, compass survey, okay, leveling, and then plane table survey, then theodolite, okay, then trigonometrical leveling, right, tachometric survey, so on, curve settings are surveying too. After studying all these things, in the advanced surveying, normally the curve settings will come, okay, in the advanced surveying. After studying all the methods, all A to Z about surveying, lastly, you'd be studying about theory of errors and adjustments. Okay. But in your syllabus, the triangulation, theory of errors and adjustments, all this advanced surveying part kept in the basic surveying theory. I don't know. It's okay. Who framed the syllabus? He has to. Okay. So I don't know on what basis it has been done. Doesn't matter. I will come to theory, right? Theory of errors and adjustments. Okay, listen to me. Actually, we do a measurement, okay? In the surveying, you determine, in order to prepare plan and map of an area, you are determining some distances. This is between points, okay? And then elevation of points and all, you are determining. Either direct measurement or indirect measurement you are doing. And you are dealing with a huge field data, okay? Your observation. You are in the field record book, you are noting down huge data, okay, by making observations to the any type of survey, whatever you do. So, obviously, there are going to be errors involved in it, right? Errors involved in it. So, some theory is available to eliminate those errors, okay? How to, by doing some means, we can some extent eliminate the error involved in it. Theory of errors and adjustments, okay? Good. Actually, kind of error, classification of errors, how to classify error, or kinds of error, or classification of error, okay? How do you classify? They are classified into, as per this textbook, mistakes, systematic errors, and accidental errors, okay? Actually, mistakes, normally everybody will do, right? It depends upon your condition that day, okay? Actually, it arises from the inattention, inexperience, and carelessness. It is even mistakes, error are arising from inattention, inexperience, carelessness, and poor judgment, or sometimes confusion in the mind of the observer. Okay, so and suppose you are very fresh, you slept well, and you are fresh, definitely there are will not be any mistakes in your observation. Suppose you didn't, you have some health issues, or you are not fresh while making observations, obviously, there are going to be mistakes. Or you are in a confused state, you have some other mind, you are thinking about some other personal issues. There are going to be confusion, or you are a careless person, or inexperienced sometimes. Experienced people will be cautious where they will do mistake, they will try to avoid it. Suppose you are doing first time, inexperienced, obviously you will be doing mistakes, okay? So those mistakes can be checked by some means and corrected, okay, by cross checking by some other observer. You can ask some other observer to cross check, okay, randomly something. Thus you can correct the mistakes later, at a later stage, okay? There's a possibility of correcting it. And then another error is systematic error. A systematic error is an error that under this same conditions, okay? Actually, this why it is called systematic. This error will be cumulative, okay, and it follows some definite mathematical or physical law. Actually, the systematic error follows some mathematical or physical law. That is why it can be eliminated by the same manner. Okay, by carrying out some same correction can be determined and applied. A correction can be determined and applied accordingly, whether the correction required is positive correction or negative correction, like that, because the result will be too great or too small, you can do it. For example, there is an error in the length of the chain or tape. Okay, if the chain is too short or too long, how to carry out correction, positive correction, negative correction, and all you know. Because the error involved will be systematic and it will be get accumulated. It follows some mathematical law, no, or physical law. It can be the same mathematical law, physical law can be applied and it can be corrected or eliminated. Okay, that is called systematic error. Right? Next one, okay, you can go through some lot of explanations are available here. Anywhere any example is given. For example, in the ordinary leveling, the leveling instrument must be first be adjusted so that the line of sight is nearly horizontal as possible. Yeah. For example, you take suppose in your instrument, leveling instrument, the bubble tube is there. If you bring the bubble at the center of the run of the bubble tube, the line of sight should be exactly horizontal. Suppose the bubble tube fitted in your level is not parallel to the line of sight of the or the axis of the telescope, what will happen? Right? Obviously, the line of sight will not be horizontal. That is a permanent systematic error involved in it. Those errors can be eliminated by doing that permanent adjustments in the instrument. Those errors can be eliminated. Okay, they are called systematic error. It get accumulated. It can be, it follows some mathematical or physical law. It can be later. Okay, slightly, please. I want to tell you one thing. The theory of error and adjustment is slightly boring, right? Slightly boring. You cannot enjoy it. It's simple computation, but easy. That's what I want to say. Without bothering about simply how to do the calculation. Definitely, you'll be getting some problem in the exams. So how to get the solution for it? That is easy. Okay, that's why I have taken it. But understanding it clearly may be slightly difficult and boring, slightly boring also, because you have studied only a little bit about surveying. Now immediately you are going for theory of errors and adjustments without studying all about surveying. Okay, I don't know who has framed the syllabus and included this one here. Earlier we used to have surveying one, surveying two, or surveying simply advanced surveying. In that last unit will be this theory of error and adjustments. Okay, but here now it's a fourth unit itself. The other two, the basic surveying theory, you are studying it. It's okay. Last one is accidental error. Accidental errors are those which remains after mistakes and systematic errors have been eliminated. As I told you, mistakes and systematic error can be eliminated, can be adjusted. Okay. Okay. After eliminating them, sometimes some error will be still there in your data that nobody knows. Okay. That they are called accidental error. Okay. A combination of reason beyond this, beyond the ability of the observer control. Actually, it is caused by the combination of reasons. Okay, these accidental errors are caused due to by a combination of reasons beyond the ability of the observer control. They tend sometimes to one direction or sometimes to other. Actually, this is not following any simple arithmetic, mathematical law or physical law. Okay, this accidental error, the true value of the quantity. Actually, the accidental error of a single determination is the difference between the true value of the quantity and the determination that is free from mistakes and the systematic error. Okay. Next. Okay. Actually, the accidental error is the difference between the true value of a quantity and the determination of that free from mistakes and systematic error. Okay. Accidental errors. What is that word? Accidental error. Repress. Okay. Limit of precision in the determination of value. Okay, that is not necessary. The theory of errors that is discussed in this chapter deals only with the accidental errors. After all the known errors are eliminated and accounted for, right? Actually, in this theory of errors and adjustments, you are going, because already the systematic, how to eliminate a systematic error, you have studied it in the linear measurement itself. If the chain is too long, too short, how to carry out adjustment. Okay, even the campus has the campus surveying, how to do carry out the error and all, you have already learned. Okay, that is because it follows strictly a mathematical law. That's why you have done it. But in this chapter, you are going to learn how to eliminate accidental error. After taking all our readings, field observations, okay, by cross-checking, by experienced people and all, you can eliminate the mistakes, what you have done, or by redoing, you can eliminate the mistakes which you have done. And all this systematic error involved due to error in the instrument, right? For example, chain is too long, too short, or that's a permanent error in your instrument, in the compass, in the leveling instrument. Those errors can be eliminated by following simple mathematical formula and all. Okay, after eliminating all those errors, still the observed quantities, okay, believed to be having with some error in it. Okay, we call them accidental error. Still, that to be, which is beyond our control. It may be combination of several reasons. Okay, so how to eliminate those accidental error? For that, there is a theory. We rely upon a theory like probability theory. Probability theory we rely upon. Okay, so probability theory very difficult to understand. That bell-shaped curve, no probability curve. But there is an expression available. Straight away you can use the expression without going too much into the theory. You can use the formula. I think it is a let us see later. Okay, definition. First, before that, law of accidental error. Actually, it is the most important formula, accidental error. But okay. Next, I will come back. I will tell you later that one. Before that, you will see some definition. Okay, this definition also you just go through. Nobody will ask. Sometimes there is a chance to ask you some this kind of definition. Okay, that is why I am telling. What is independent quantity? An observed quantity may be classified as independent or conditioned. Okay, an independent quantity is the one whose value is independent of the values of other quantities. Okay, you are carrying out leveling. The benchmark is there. That is a quantity. You want to determine the elevations of the given points. You want to establish what is the elevation value of several given points. That benchmark is the independent quantity. Okay, while the other quantities are going to be depend on the benchmark. Okay, so that is called independent quantity. That's what the observed quantity may be classified as independent or conditioned. An independent quantity is the one whose value is independent of the values of the other quantities in your surveying. Okay, for example, what is that independent value of the other quantities? Other quantities does not affect the value of this quantity. Example, reduced levels of several benchmarks. Reduced levels means an RL, okay, reduced levels, elevations of several benchmarks. So it is an independent quantity. Next, conditioned quantity. Okay, conditioned quantity is the one whose value depend upon values of one or more quantities. For example, in a triangle, you are measuring the angle, okay, the corner angle, included angle in it. You are measuring in a triangle ABC. Angle A and A, angle B plus angle C equal to one, it must be 180 degree. That is a law. There is a law available, condition available. That condition is required to be satisfied. Okay, out of these three angles, two angles are known to be independent quantities, while the third one is known to be conditioned quantity. Okay, conditioned quantity. Any one of the angle is known to be conditioned quantity. If you take the others, two are independent quantity. Okay. That's what this is another the theory simple explanation. Okay, whether you like it or not, you have to read them, right? No problem. Direct observations. So the measurement we do many times directly. You are the distance between a baseline, you are measuring straight away by putting your chain on the ground. That is called direct observation. Or indirectly also we can do by carrying out this already we have seen. Lot of the chain surveying we have seen how to determine by constructing simple geometrical figure, how to determine distance between two points and all we have seen there, that is indirect measurement. Or in your leveling also, tachometric surveying also, you have learned how to determine distance between points. Okay, distance between your instrument station and the elevated point, the horizontal distance between, shortest horizontal distance between your instrument station and the elevated point D, that is indirect measurement. Okay. These are the quantity, direct observation. An observation is the numerical value of a measured quantity. And maybe either direct or indirect, Okay, a direct observation is the one made directly on the quantity being determined. Okay, for example, measurement of a base, a single measurement of an angle, etc. Okay, and then indirect observation. Indirect observation is the one which is the observed value is deduced from the measurement of some other values, some other quantities. The okay, by measuring some other quantities, it is deduced. Okay, by maintaining the relation between the quantities, the measurement of angle by repetition method. They give an example. Measurement of angle by repetition method. If you want to measure the included angle between AOB, you want to measure angle AOB, okay. In a traversing, you want to measure. So by using theodolite, what we do? There is a method, a reiteration method, repetition method. Repetition means in order to eliminate error, we will measure several times. Okay, three times. Then that divided by total angle, okay, divided by 3 will give you the actual angle. That is said indirect observation. And not only this, I told you just now one example, no, the tachometric surveying example, distance, equation for distance and V. They are indirect measurement, okay. That is the best example for indirect measurement, right. Next, weight of an observation. Weight of an observation means the weight of an observation is a number giving an indication of its precision and trustworthiness. Okay, the weight of an observation is a number giving an indication of its precision and trustworthiness when making a comparison between several quantities of different worthiness. Okay, thus, if a certain observation is of weight 4, it means that is 4 times as much reliable as an observation of weight 1. Okay, when two quantities or observations are assumed to be equally reliable, the observed values are said to be of equal weight or unit weight. Okay, the observations are called weighted when different weights are assigned to them. Observations are required to be weighted when they are made with unequal care and under dissimilar conditions. Okay, weight are assigned to be to the observer or quantities observed in direct proportion to the number of observations. Okay, now I understood what it says. Actually, the weight depends on the accuracy, okay, the worthiness, trustworthiness of it, the quantity. For example, in identical condition you are doing, the same condition you are measuring, doing some measurement, you can assign the same weightness to those quantities. For example, one, especially you are doing direct measurement, you can say its worthiness is trustworthiness is high. You can assign more weightage to that quantity. For example, you are measuring the distance between a baseline by direct measurement, directly putting chain on the ground. Now the precision of that value, trustworthiness, is high now. Okay, so you can assign a weightage number of 4 or 5 to that quantity. Suppose the same distance you are obtaining by indirect measurement. Okay. By constructing simple geometry, by taking some included angle, length of baseline, and applying this formula for the geometry, and you are computing the distance between two points. That is indirect measurement. There, the trustworthiness is low. Okay, precision is somewhat comparatively low. For that quantity, you can assign a weightage of only 1. Okay. Moreover, you are carrying out a survey in a different environment, okay, different condition. One day the climate is very good, you are doing, okay, and taking observation. You are confident about your observation, right? So you can assign weightage, it's a trustworthiness. You can assign some weightage of 3. Suppose the continuity of that same survey, the climate is not good, it's raining or some other disturbance. In that hurry manner you are doing it, okay, because of raining or raining may come in a different climatic condition, you are carrying out the survey. That time you can assign less trustworthiness to that quantity. Weightage can be reduced, okay. We can assign one or two for it, right? That's what this weight of an observation deals with. It depends on, okay, you have to decide. If the quantity measured is trustworthiness, you can assign more weightage. If you feel suppose in the identical condition, if you measure, all will be with the same weightage of one, right? Something like that. it all you have to decide, right? Observed value of a quantity. Observed value of a quantity. And observed value of a quantity is the value obtained when it is correct for all the known errors. When it is corrected for all the known errors, okay? That is called observed value of the quantity. You are making some observation, you are measuring, and whatever errors are involved in it, you are correcting it. Suppose you are measuring distance between a baseline, and you know the chain is too short, or it has some error, too long. You are carrying out the correction, okay? That is called observed value of a quantity. True value of the quantity. The true value of the quantity is the value which is absolutely free from all errors, okay? The true value of the quantity is indeterminate, since the true is never known. That's what they conclude. See, the true value of a quantity is never known, right? It is, and the true value of a quantity is indeterminate. It's indeterminate. It's never known, right? We are doing our level best to get. We are trying to go closer to the true value. When you do surveying, it's not a 100% true value, right? Some extent, 99.99%, we may are making it. That's all. Next, most probable value. The most probable value of a quantity is the one which has more chances of being true. Okay, the most probable value of a quantity is the one which has more chances of being true than has any other. It deduced from the several measurement on which it is based. Okay. Next, most probable value means the most probable value of a quantity is the one which has more chances of being true. No, that's all. Next, true error. The true error is the difference between the true value of the quantity and the observed value, right? Actually, I thought of skipping it. Better, something's better than nothing. Sometimes in the question, if you get one or two, what is the most probable error? Somebody asks, you have to give the explanation. No, that's why I'm anyway. You may get question in any manner. Let us see. Most probable error. The true error means the true error is the difference between the true value of the quantity and the observed value. Okay. So true value is known, not known. I told you, but okay. But definition, let us understand them. Most probable error. The most probable error is the defined as that quantity which added to and subtracted from. The most probable value fixes the limit within which it is an even chance the true value of the measured quantity must lie. It's okay. The most probable error means the most probable error is defined as that quantity which added to, okay, which added to or subtracted from the most probable value. Okay, that's what, right? That is the observed quantity. With that, the most probable error means from the most probable value itself, you can tell it. It is the error, the quantity which can be added or subtracted from the observed value is called a most probable error. That's okay. Let it be. Let's residual error. A residual error is the difference between most probable value of the, okay, all this explanation may not record, I think. Observation equation, conditioned equation, not necessary. It's okay. Leave it. Because it is there in your textbook, just I am discussing. Normally, later you go through, but may not important. The law of accidental error. Now I am coming to the law of accidental error. Okay, law of accidental error. I told you in this chapter, you are going to study how to adjust for accidental errors. Okay, good. Investigations of observations of various types show that accidental errors follow a definite law. Accidental errors follow a definite law. Now, earlier they said not the definite law means law of probability. It's not a simple equation, sir. Mathematical law or some physical law, it is a law of probability. Okay, this law defines the occurrence of error and can be expressed in the form of equation. Okay, this law is expressed in the form of equation. It is used to compute the probable value of the probable precision of the quantity. To get the probable value or probable precision of the quantity, some simple mathematical expressions are developed. Okay. By applying probability theory, law of probability, right? So probability curve is shown here. Size of error, number of errors, 10, 20, 30, 40, to 30, okay, here. The peak comes, right? It's a bell-shaped curve, distribution curve. Size of error, it is given minus 0.6, minus 0.4, 0.2, 0.2, 0.4, 0.6. Don't ask me anything about this chart, okay? It is given as probability curve. In the below the curve itself, it is given this curve called the curve of error or probability curve form the basis for the mathematical derivation of theory of errors. The formula for probability error is difficult to derive. It is stated here categorically stated. Okay. Teaching probability theory is somewhat difficult. For that you have to study, undergo one full mathematical course. Okay, so not necessary. Just straight away some formula is given. Using this formula you can do some problem, right? Yeah, it's given here. Probable error of a single measurement, right? You have done some single measurement, you have taken so many readings, out of which you take one reading, right? Single measurement. What is the probable error of a single measurement? Some expression is given, okay, based on probability theory. We need not go too much into detail of the probability theory. Similarly, we will memorize, mug up this formula. E suffix s is equal to plus or minus